Alright everyone, welcome back to another Star Wars Galaxy Fears video with Fat Phil, and in this video we're going to be talking about signal data. And if you remember back, I was doing a series where I was kind of going through the different bottlenecks in this game, and for this one we're going to be looking at signal data. We're going to look at some of the issues that drive it, particularly kind of take you guys through how I think you can solve this problem. And it's a problem that is probably the most difficult problem in Galaxy of Heroes, and we'll kind of go into some of those details. I'll give you guys some farming tips and tricks, as well as giving you advice on if you should be buying it, which one to buy. So make sure you guys like and subscribe, comment down below. I would really appreciate your support on this channel. And again, huge, massive shout out to my channel members. You all are unbelievable. Thank you so much for your continued support. If you're interested in joining channel memberships, there's a link in the video description down below. But again, guys, just even supporting this channel with a subscribe and like and comment is massive as well. So thank you guys so much. Really appreciate it. Let's get into the game here. So, signal data is a huge issue, and there's a lot of reasons why signal data is a big problem. So it's Cantina only, right? The nodes that it's on is Cantina, and it's the only resource in this game that is not available for some sort of currency or other area of the game. Like, that you think of, I mean, the only other piece I could think of maybe would be Aero Magnifiers you can buy with raid currency. You can get them, like, I guess raid currency, maybe like Relic 8 and Relic 9 materials. But in terms of like a common resource, signal data is the only one that is not available for some form of currency. That you cannot go and use raid currency, get 3, things like that for signal data. The only ways to get signal data are with crystals, farming nodes, and there's another area we'll cover that, so that you can actually like actively go and farm them. So it is a very rare thing, and it's one of the most common pieces in this game. In fact, you're going to need more signal data in this game than you will ever. Kyrotex will cover that as well. So it's crazy, right? And again, remember, there's the three nodes for it, for those of you who, you know, maybe live under a rock or haven't quite got here yet. It's in Cantina 8, 16 energy nodes, and they are also the only nodes that you can earn Omicrons on. The rest of these, you can at least get Omegas, but these ones you can earn Omicron materials. I'm not saying the drop rate is great, but it's a little added bonus for farming signal data. Just want to throw that. You got to throw that in there, right? That, you know, you can get that. So the other place you can get this is the Conquest Scavenger. So when Conquest is active in the Scavenger, and I'm not sure if below hard mode if it's available, but I know in hard mode, I have the option to buy signal data. And that's kind of why I said it's like a unique resource in that you can go into Conquest, go buy that, you know, signal data. And I'd say especially if you're in a position where you're not going to be obtaining a character in 6 Conquests, buying the signal data is like your best bet. Because you think if you can't get that character within a certain number of Conquests, you're stuck. Right, you're stuck. You're not getting them until they're hitting Proving Grounds or you're spending other resources to get there. Comparative to signal data helping your account today. So just something that I want to mention, I use my excess Conquest currency actually for signal data. And that has been a huge boost to my account in terms of how quickly I've been able to grow. Now, you also get it passively from Conquest. And when I talk about passively and I talk about secondary and primary, your primary is, hey, I'm going to this place for the sole purpose of doing this. That when you go and farm a character node, your primary objective is, I'm going to get those resources. That's your primary objective, is I want to get that character shard. Any of the other stuff you get, the gear pieces that are on there, maybe there's another character that you're not quite ready to farm yet, but you're getting shards for, that's secondary, right? It's not primary, it's a secondary thing that you're like, you're still doing something, but it's just part of the main thing that you're going for. And that's kind of the way I feel with Conquest, that you're primarily doing Conquest for the rewards of the character shards, and you're getting some passive signal data along with it. You'll also get signal data passively through territory battles, where again, you've kind of done all this stuff for territory battles. Hey, at the end, we're going to throw in some signal data. It definitely took a bigger jump in Rise of the Empire comparative to what you got for Lightside Geonosis, but it still helps, right? It's better than nothing. So you do get some from TB. And then finally, the big one is Assault Battles. Now, what I don't like people saying is, oh, you got to rush to get to your assault battle so you can start earning signal data. It's going to take you forever to earn back the signal data for a specific squadron. Just like I had said with Kyratex, it's going to take you a very long time to ever actually get a return on your investment through assault battles. It's why I don't recommend that you just rush to get to assault battles and throw all this gear on the characters, because it's not sustainable to do it that way. Now, you've gone and built those characters because they're part of a Galactic Legend farm, because they're a very good team, and the added bonus is, hey, I get to do well in assault battles. Then game on, you did it right, and you're getting, you know, you're killing multiple birds with one stone. Again, big, you guys notice that's a recurring theme on this channel. Trying to do as much as you can with as little as possible. That you want to try and check as many boxes on something, get it all done at once. So that's the one thing with assault battles, that you're never going to get your return on investment through signal data. Or if you do, it's going to take, you know, years and years and years and years and years. So just something to think about, guys. Again, I'm not trying to say that, you know, it's not nice, but it's not something you should be working towards with the sole purpose of getting your signal data back from that. It's an added bonus, in my mind, it's an added bonus for building a very good, solid team. So I want to go into a farming analysis here. So I want to show you guys a little bit of, hey, here's the shipment cost, what it kind of takes in Cantina, and it'll give you guys perspective on where my mind is in terms of which one to buy, how to go about doing that. So we're going to actually switch over to a Google Doc that I made. But of course it's doing this. Hold on. Let's get there. Come on, thing. There we go. There we go. All right, hold on, guys. I promise we're getting there. All right, we're back in the game now. You guys can see the game. Okay, and boom. There we go. Technical difficulties. I apologize. All right. So here is my signal data thing. So you guys can see here that I've got the three kinds of signal data, right? Your fragmented, your incomplete, and your flawed signal data. Now, your shipment costs are right here, that it's going to cost you 1,500 crystals to get 100 pieces of fragmented signal data, which comes out to 15 crystals per piece. For incomplete, it's a 20 crystal per piece, right, for that. And then for the flawed, it's a 30 crystals per piece. So what I then came down here and did was show you what your Cantina break-even point is. This is how many, if you spend 100 crystal energy, you know, 100 energy refresh, this is how many of the signal data that you need to earn in order to break even. So you look, I need 6.67. Basically, you know, if you do a 3 refreshes, you need 20 total signal data from those refreshes, and you broke even. That you spent 300 crystals, you got 200, you know, got 20 signal data back, you broke even. For the green signal data, you need to get to 5, which is, you know, not that hard to do with this. Again, that's a 15 crystal savings there, or 15, you know, total over those refreshes. And then finally, you know, you need 3.3 repeating or 10 over the course of 3 crystal, you know, 3 100 crystal refreshes. So that's your break-even point, that if you can do that over your crystal refreshes, you broke even comparative to what you could buy in shipments. So this fat fill average is just my brain kind of recollecting of what I normally get when I refresh these nodes. And again, this 10, I actually feel pretty confident with. I feel like I get a lot of these every single day. So, you know, call this 10 here. Call these 7 and these 4. And I'll show you guys, we'll tweak the numbers a little bit, and I will link this in the video description so you guys can check it out if you want. But, you know, if you average that, you know, that per 100 crystals, this is what I'm getting out of the Cantina. You look, I'm saving 50 crystals when I do that. It costs 15 crystals per piece, which would cost me 150 crystals, right? Your math here, right? This is 150 minus 100 gets me down to 50, because I would have spent 150 crystals via shipments. I farmed it with 100 crystals. I saved 50. So every single day that I do that, I'm technically saving my roster 150 crystals compared to if I went and just bought them via the store. With the green signal data, again, the math works the same way, a few different numbers, but it comes out to 120 crystals a day. And then finally with the blue at four of those pieces a day, you're looking at about a 60 crystal savings. So right there, if you pause, that's my, you know, now if we bump this up, let's say we keep this the same. Let's say I bump this to 8. All of a sudden, look at that. I'm at, you know, 180. And if I bump this up a full 1 to 5, I'm now at 150. Now getting 5 of these every single refresh is going to be pretty tough. I'm not going to lie. So let's say you even kept this at 4.5. You're at 105. And let's say you made this 7.5. You're at the same crystal savings here. And again, if I made this 5, they're all the same. But I don't think I can average 5 for those. I feel like 4 is probably a conservative number. Maybe if you said 4.5. Even if we go 4.5, you're still below what the other ones are. That you're not saving as many crystals when you do the flawed signal data as you are when you do the incomplete and the fragmented, at least with the fat fill numbers. Again, scientifically backed and had nothing, no way, just came like right through my brain of what I think I can do. But why I mention these things, why I bring this up, why I think this is important to understand, is that when you go and think about which one you want to buy in shipments, you're going to lose crystals no matter what. It's better to farm this than it is to buy in shipments. That's what this is proving out to you. However, what you have to take into account when you're buying something out of shipments is the time savings involved. That for you to get 50 of these pieces at this drop rate, right, at this one right here at 4.5 of those a day, right? So you think we're going to do this, multiply it by 3, I get 13. I don't want to autofill. I'm just doing math off to the side here. And then I do that at 50 divided by that 13.5, right? It's going to take me like almost 4 days to get that much signal data. So you tell me, you know, how much is that time savings really worth? Again, I'm just making an argument here. So when you break it down like that, you think about the time savings, you think about some of the other stuff, that's what you're paying crystals for. And again, with the blue signal data, as I'm showing here, if you are going to buy one, I'd buy the blues. One, they take so much longer, but two, it comes down to the fact that you don't get as good of a return on your crystals in the cantina, in my personal opinion, as you do with the green and the white. Again, that's just my 2 cents, that for what I can do with them in the cantina, I feel I can do a lot better with the white and the green than I can the blue. Now, if we go back to our game here, there we go, back into the game. So what's kind of the, you know, I get it, right? You know, I've been ranting about signal data. So Phil, like, get to the point. So the scariest part though with signal data, as I go on here, the scariest part is that if they go and release a relic level beyond relic 9, it's going to require more signal data. Because if we go to just our king here for a second, right? Our king at relic 8, he still needs 55 signal data here. 55 blue, 30, and 30. If we go to someone who is, say, relic 7, like my Grand Inquisitor was in this thing down here, right? Grand Inquisitor is relic 7. To go to relic 8, I need 20, 25, and 45. Okay, and then finally, I'll just show Commander Tana. We'll go to Commander Tana real quick. I think she's in here at Relic 6. Yeah, a Relic 6 needs 20, 25, and 35. So the signal data ramps the further and further you go. And that can be really problematic for this game, that if we get a Relic 10 and that signal data ramps up yet again, that ramps up for every single character in the game. That's what's so scary. With Kyratex, with Core Gear, all those things, they go on a character, you don't ever need them again, right? There's no gear 14. There's nothing else that you have to do. They're done. But if they add Relic 10, you need that much more signal data for every single character in the game. And that's the one thing I always say that's so scary with signal data is I don't feel that there's enough ways to get this. I'll say that now. I don't feel there's enough ways to get signal data as shown. And if they add another relic level, that's the reason I think if they tried to add another relic level, that the game would fail, is that you're adding that for every single character in a game where we're already starved for signal data. So my advice, there's not this magic trick of you farm this, you do, like, you guys saw that it's still best to farm your signal data. The bonus crystals is where you need to be smart with, that if you're going to use your bonus crystals, use them to buy the blues, because that's where you're going to lose the least amount of money comparative to the other ones. But the big thing is just use it sparingly. You guys can see, like, I've got Maul at Relic 7, Starkiller Relic 5, Iden Relic 3. I'd love all these characters to be Relic 9. You know, heck, I'd even just like if I could get them all to Relic 7, but it's not in the cards. You have to ask yourself the questions of what will they do at X Relic level that they can't do now. And if you find that your character's getting there, as I always tell you guys, that's when you bump them up. But I wouldn't just go and throw Relic levels on a character because it looks cool. Like, it looks so cool to have a Relic 7, Relic 8 Star Killer. Who doesn't want that? Who doesn't want our king to be Relic 8? Like, it looks awesome. But is it really something that your account needs? And if your account doesn't, save that signal data and invest it in something that you're going to get a return on, like a Galactic Legend requirement or somebody that you could use in a raid or whatever else. Because it is such a, it's the one resource that I feel is the scarcest. And that's saying a lot, because there are a lot of scarce resources in this game, but because of the cantina and the fact that you need to balance character farming in there with, you know, ships and then signal data on top of it, it is the only resource like that that is truly available, because Relic 8, Relic 9, I really shouldn't count them, you know, if you're still watching from, like, the beginning. Shouldn't really count them because they're so different, but signal data is the only one that you can't use a currency for like you can everything else, because even, like, relic materials, just for the sake of argument, even these things, I can go and buy these with guild currencies. I cannot do that with signal data. So it is the only resource that way. And it drives me crazy because it's the one resource that you need just so much of. And if they bump up another relic level, you need that much more of it immediately. So that's my video on signal data, guys. Let me know your thoughts. It's unfortunate, but there's not really this solid trick into, hey, like, this is what you do, and this is why you do it. Like, it just, it's not a, you know, trick to getting it, because it's just go and farm it is the best answer. Well, using your bonus crystals on the blue, which is where I think you get the least amount of return. I'm sure somebody else will tell you something different. Again, do your own analysis and tell me what you think about that. You know, go do your own analysis and you tell me what it is. I'd love to hear from you guys. Make sure you like, subscribe, comment down below. I love all you. May the force be with you. I'll see you guys in the next video. Cheers.